The approach of the New Madrid Bicentennial is a unique opportunity for researchers and emergency managers in the central United States to increase earthquake awareness related to the New Madrid seismic zone and other seismic sources in the eastern United States. To this end, the Center for Earthquake Research and Information and the USGS have partnered to inform the public on what we can do to prepare for earthquakes, as well as to work with engineers on appropriate measures to enact in buildings to make them stronger from ground motions. So the retrofit of the Memphis I-40 bridge is probably the most high-profile project. That's a $200 million project to guarantee that this major artery for central United States distribution will be there after a large earthquake, a magnitude 7 or even larger. Memphis is also home to the largest cargo airport in the world by volume, larger than LAX or any other, largely due to the presence of the Federal Express Company that's based here. Memphis has about 300,000 structures, many of them built before there were any seismic codes or for even wind. So it's very important to, as we go through and replace buildings or remodel buildings, that we try and enforce the building codes to make them stronger for earthquakes in the future. Well, building codes don't generally apply to existing structures unless they change the use of that structures. But many building owners, as they make improvement to their structures, choose to find engineers and researchers who can help them with the state-of-the-art methods that are cost-effective to make the building stronger for earthquakes. The AutoZone building in downtown Memphis is the corporate headquarters for AutoZone. It's built on base isolators, very similar to what you would find in some facilities in California or more seismically active areas. These corporate leaders see that it's very cost-effective to improve the integrity of their structures to survive earthquakes, not only just if it was a very high probability event, but even for the lower probability events that have very high consequences, such as a New Madrid earthquake.